That inspired me and a local artist, Marielis Burgos Melendez, which is a dancer who is from Puerto Rico, to do a slow walk in the Puerto Rico Avenue last week, both as a gesture towards her home country, by being aware of what is around her, and also by interacting with the people around in this slowness, because this is. People ask you questions. Why are you going so slow? Why? What is happening? For me, walking is as an artist, as a curator, a constant movement in and inspiration in what I do. And this brings me around the world. It's a pleasure to work with students, with inhabitants, with residents, and with labs around the world that dedicate themselves to walking. And that's the reason why I came to the United States. In New York, there is a walking lab at Parsons. That is what's followed by a small tour of the Northeast, going to Portland, where at Mecca, there is a lab dedicated to walking. And this brought me here as well in Boston with you and other dedicated people to walking, coming to take part of what I would like to present today. This is not always evident. I was invited to start a lab in Cyprus, in Nicosia, by the local university. Actually, they gave me residency for 6 months, and the first meeting I had, when I was starting to talk about walking as an art, they sort of looked at me with a suspicion. They had a very hostile, very strange glance in their eyes. They were thinking that I was making fun of them, and actually they were convinced that I was making fun of them. And some of them started even to leave the auditorium. The ones that persevered and continued listening to me, after a while, their hostility was changing. Actually, they started to look at me with pity in their eyes. They were really thinking, this guy is crazy and he is not aware of it. Why would you do something that doesn't produce something? Why would you do something that has no intention? Why would you do something that has no material trace? And what can we as artists, as young artists, do with that? This changed completely, this attitude, after I made the first walk with them. And that's, of course, the irony of our gathering as well. We are here to talk about walking, but actually walking is something that only exists in the experience of doing it together. Now, the presentation of today starts with a very difficult word, even more difficult than my name, which I will pronounce again. My name is Geert Vermeijeren. And the concept that brought me to walking is Spaziergangwissenschaft. It's a German word. It's even one of the shortest German words. So you're lucky. Spaziergang is the German word for walk. Spaziergehen, spazier is fun. Gehen is to go, to move around by foot. And Wissenschaft is the German word for science. The Spaziergangwissenschaft is a concept that was introduced by Lucius Burckhardt, which was living in Kassel, was a professor of architecture. Now, Lucius Burckhardt was the one who came up with the concept and idea of Spaziergangwissenschaft as a professor of architecture in Kassel. That was in the early 80s. He was a friend and a colleague of the Josef Beuys, who, together with Lucius Burckhardt, were two prominent figures in the city. They were not artists or scholars that stayed inside. They were coming outside in the streets, interacting with people. Joseph Beuys is known by his social sculpture, which meant that the fabric of the inhabitants was for him the basis for all his works, creative work that he did in the city. And Lucius Boodgaard, although not an artist, had the same attitude towards bringing people together in an attempt to change the city. His idea was to bring together a subjective perception with the science. And I'll go. So by inviting people to walk together on a way, they would make the invisible visible, and at the same time to reflect about the conditions in which they, in their urban environment, they were living. Two of his walks were the motorists' walks, which was reenacted in 1993 by Bertrand Weisgaard. Another example of spatial wissenschaft action is the walkmobile, or the Gehzeug, by Hermann Knoflacher. He walked around with an installation around him which represented the distance or the amount of space that the car takes. The Spaziergangwissenschaft has the basic idea that the landscape exists in your mind. Actually, it only exists in your mind. It is a perception, and as such, as being a present in your mind, you can change it, you can transform it. It's about generating new visions, new ideas about the landscape, but as well making walking and making movement in the landscape through this perceiving, to this inner walking. He was talking about a mind walk as a creative act, as an act. Walking is active, it's not passive. And this is something you don't do alone. Spaziergangwissenschaft was based on walking together in groups with experts, with researchers, with artists, which invite you to change your perception of your environment. It is like I showed you in the example. It is about showing possibilities. It's about showing what can be. And what is invisible through small interventions like this zebra-streifen that were put on the street in Kassel as well. Now, what inspired me in the Spaziergangwissenschaft was the fact that you can walk together and that walking is actually a creative act, that as an artist you can use a walk to make a change, to make a transformation of the landscape around you, even if that is not a direct material change. And the fact that it is something you share. Sharing is extremely important, is essential in my work, which is also reflected in the gathering, as you correctly described it, that is called Made of Walking. And that happened last summer in Delphi and La Romieu, bringing together in the two places 80 artists, dancers, movement artists, researchers, people from all sorts of disciplines to share, to learn, to question, and to bring together their practices related to walking in the landscape and to listening to sound. The Made of Walking in Delphi is in a marvelous landscape. And it is inviting to make a pilgrimage, to follow the steps of pilgrims that actually in the ancient times arrived by boat behind the mountains you see on the photograph, and then came up following the path towards the holy site where the Pythia was giving her advice. And still, the ancient path is present. The path you see on the photograph is the path that the pilgrims were following during their walk up to the Parnassus Mountain, to the holy site. The whole idea about this gathering was about contextualizing and making contemporary pilgrimage by inviting people from around the world to give their interpretation or an artistic way of how a pilgrimage today can be. An example of that is the installation The Vows by Aliki Arnauti, who brought together two traditions. A tradition in Russia in which you leave behind a scarf, you bind a scarf around a place that you pass as a sort of promise to come back one day. And in Turkey, you do this to leave a vow behind, to make a vow. This brings together different traditions, but as well makes it very relevant towards how people move today without having the certainty ever to come back. Not everybody has the possibility to make a work out of an aesthetical or out of an experiential intention. Some people have to work to survive and have no certainties. So in Made of Walking, the interaction with the residents, with local inhabitants, is always present. I'll take another. The local woman of the village of Delphi were invited to create a work of art together with a young Cypriot artist that was called Found Wet by knitting parts together in one big web that was created together on location. And that actually symbolized the whole idea of this gathering, which was making a web of walkers. This work was then later used in another performance and is now as well going around in other places where we organize our walking gatherings. Key performance and action and workshop of Made of Walking in Delphi was called The Tortoise and the Spider. The Tortoise and the Spider was a collaborative performance that was based on an idea of me together with Ross Band, which is an Australian sound artist, and Katrina Dacopulo, who is a dancer, in the creation of a web of walkers. Together with the participants, the idea was to start from a Greek ancient harp, a lyra, which is made out of the carapace of a tortoise, with strings that are attached over it, and to extend this lyra, which stands for the Greek ancient traditions, with strings connecting walkers that make a pilgrimage at night up to the Parnassus Mountain, connected as well with speakers that are triggered by their movements on certain places they pass, creating a live composition by their movements and inviting other people to walk with them in a contemporary pilgrimage up to the mountain of the Mount Parnassus. This is part of my personal artistic practice. I'm not only interested in walking as an analog art form, in trying to augment awareness of your environment, to make transformation, mutant spaces through the walking experiences by slowing down or silence, or but as well using technology as a way to enhance this walking experience. So this cooperation with Ross involved the use of technology, of sound, in creating a field of sounds that were generating through movement and through walking. I'll play you a little video. performance was not the end, it was a beginning. A beginning that is continued in an online digital platform that brings together and makes a web of walkers around the world, which will be now be presented and put online in Melbourne in Australia, the 22nd of November. The Made of Walking in Delphi was based on live electronics, sound, in a technological way, and creating a web of walkers. The sister event Made of Walking in La Romieux, France, where I met Wendy, was based on listening in a more traditional way to the landscape and to the others. La Romieux, as Delphi, is a very small village. It has only 150 people living in the center, but has an importance because it's a place on the path, on the pilgrim's route to Santiago de Compostela, where 20,000 pilgrims, a year are passing through. There we invited a series of artists to give their interpretation and to give their view on how pilgrimage today is. Among others, what was Karel Manke. I'll give you a very short clip to give you an idea of how a workshop can be. Carol is interested in how circular movements and as well itineraries can change a way of thinking, specifically when you do it together. How you can collaboratively, participatively think together, and bringing in the element of making a walk in this process of coming to a collective decision-making, a collective thought-making, how this interacts with walking as a whole. This connects it again with Spaziergangwissenschaft, which is actually about that. Spaziergangwissenschaft is an alternative way of communication, of participation, and a way of knowledge. Walking in the Spaziergangwissenschaft comes to a knowledge about the place by being inside it, by being inside of the landscape, not thinking about it from the outside. Another example of a performance that was done in Made of Walking in La Romieux is a literature performance that was built on a very long text written by Peter Yeager, poet from Canada, who visited and wrote his experiences and experiences of other pilgrims down in a text that reflects walking and pilgrimage in Asia, Europe, Middle East, around the world. His idea was to bring back this text to a place where pilgrims are passing by, blending the reading, blending the sound of the text with the environmental sounds of people passing by and of the nature around. The interesting about this was as well that this was a very long, several hours durational performance, representing the idea of a walk. A walk you don't do for 5 minutes. A walk is a long process, a physical process, and this reading became as well an image of this path to reading. An another artist that is playing with reading and with movement at the same time is Inke Castellijn. She brings you to listening, starting from reading aloud a series of words, texts, inspired by what monks in the past did in Holland and Flanders, and what was called brevieren, taking a little book and walking around the cloister as a meditative practice, becoming the very intensely focused on the text during walking and as a prayer. Starting with that, she invited the participants to walk in circles and then afterwards in lines to come to an open field where she was making a relation between the cloister of the La Remieux church with the Tholos in Delphi. She was last year one of the participating artists in Delphi, Greece. And there you have a round temple, which is called the Tholos. It's the Athena Protina. It's the temple of Athena. It's one of the few round temples in Greece. And by connecting through a walk, the round walk in the cloister, with the round circle made people in the field, she wanted to recreate this Tholos. I'm making an imaginary connection between the two places of pilgrimage in Greece and in France. Another approach was by two Canadians, Pam Patterson and Lena Rodvey, who came for a very inner and personal experience. They organized four performances, of which only one was public, and which was a goodbye. They have a 20-year artist practice in which all their performances were open for the public. And from now on, they decided only to make private performances. And their performance in La Remieux was the last public performance they did by asking people to make a walk for them, connecting them in this goodbye. Sitting both of them on a chair, first in a place where they could not see each other, connected by walkers, and then coming closer towards each other as a very poetical gesture of meeting and letting go. Now, another approach was by the American Julie Poitras Santos, who invited me to come to Portland. Who has a lab in the Mecca. Work is centered around getting lost. And she invited people to walk a spiral, which is an important symbol in pilgrimage as well, because it's a way inside and a way outside at the same time. By walking a spiral, you go to the inside. By walking out of it, you even if you have this constant inner movement in a, maybe you can see it, no. Let me see. You can see it here. You walk out of it, but at the same time, you keep walking in. It's a very strange feeling. That is a little bit like getting lost, not going which direction you go anymore. So after this experience, this collective experience of walking together a spiral, she gathered the people around the circle and asking them to tell a story about when and how they got lost once in their lives. Another artist was Portuguese artist originating from Mozambique, who was fascinated by plants, by the vegetal world, and wanted to connect this with light, which is very important in the medieval and Renaissance churches. So she invited the people to experiment with all sorts of ways to create light and at the same time to use plants to make illuminations like glass, like in a church. And a last artist that I want to present to you to show all these different approaches you can have towards walking pilgrimage in these ancient places is the Finnish artist Tiran Baibulat. She has the habit to make representations of her works, not to videos or writing or maps or scores, but by knitting her works into her clothes. Every thread, every color, every distance you see has a meaning and represents a part of a work that she did, which is reconstructed by hundreds of photographs she makes during these walks. So it's a very accurate, precise reconstruction of every step that she made. It has something very meditative, very focused as well, to try to get so much into walking that every detail is preserved. And then my contribution and my work, which is based on silence. Silence in the sense that for me, silence brings people together. It's a connecting force. And in my work with walking the landscape, I invite people to walk together in different forms and formats. That can be with two people, it can be with 10 people. Landscapes that they don't know yet, that they walk for the first time. Because for me, the definition of an artistic walk is actually a walk like you experience, like you do for the first time in your life. And to invite as well artists, researchers, and other people to places that are very remote or unknown, or where you normally will not go, except if you have a very specific reason, like a gathering like this. It's also inviting for people to discover together for the first time an environment, which is part of this Made of Walking event. An artistic walk can be as simple as that. Silent observation of yourself, of the others, and being in the moment. Reflecting again to the how the pilgrim was in ancient times. A pilgrim didn't have anything. He was walking only with a cloak, with a stick, that was meant to protect himself against animals, and a little pouch, which is represented by the little thing behind the stick, which was always half open. Half open because it was meant to share, even the little things he had was meant to share with others. So walking is a sharing. Walking is an inner experience, and that is what we try to share in La Rambieux as well. The Made of Walking events are in a series of events happening in small places and will continue in the coming years in other remote villages. So it is all connected by a network. Now it's a network in which 750 people have gathered already, following the experiences of the people that were there and hoping to find new participants for the coming years. So you're most, you're invited to be part of that as well and have a look on our, the page on Facebook to find out more about it. Made of Walking is one of the two projects I'm working on on this moment that is related to walking. And another one is not only dedicated to walking, but also to silence. And it is called Urban Emptiness. It has the same approaches, but it is happening in a more urban environment. It's we can call it as well a gathering, because it brings together the various people and organizations around the exploration of silence in contemporary cities. In the same with the same intention to make aware of the imaginary, the hidden, what is not immediately visible or perceivable in the urban landscape. It's as well about sharing, about intimacy, about simultaneous the experiences, inviting people in different and groups in different places to walk together, not only in the same location, but as well in locations that are in different places of the world. It brings together as well not only artists, but as well researchers and other people that have an interest in walking in all possible fields, from educational, healthcare, over psychology, sociology, the sound studies, and so on, as well trying to stimulate and to invite young artists and students to work with the topics we give them, silence and walking. The network is now, since 2015, grown towards various cities, which are now Edinburgh, Brussels, New York, Nicosia, and the Athens. They invite the, like I said, the people that work specifically with movement, like dancers, choreographers, and people that walk as an artistic discipline, to share their experiences and explore the possibilities for their creative work, and as well to find ways, new ways of knowledge, of mapping with researchers that work in the same field of urban movement space, and to explore the city out of the trying to reveal the qualities of place. That's why we work specifically with walking in this project, silent walking, in the intention to create this possibility, this openness for what is around you, this augmented awareness in finding the quality of a place. This, as in my introduction, referring to Spaziergangwissenschaft, is not an individual the endeavor. It's always done together. The silent walking comes together by doing it in a group and sharing this experience afterwards in the creation and in the sharing of content, meaning about places together. The performative is very important in the sense that a silent walk is, even if it is a non-intentional act, it's a performance. It's a creative act. It wants to make a change. It wants to create a vision. It wants to to trigger an imaginary layer of the city. And it does combine in our work as well with using technology. So we use locative media and other technologies like soundwalks to get to this experience of silence in the city. Silence is so important for us because it's a very immersive experience. It's an experience in which you can completely disappear and creates the possibility to be aware on a different way of what's around you by changing your perception. Silence for us is not an absolute it's not a thing, it's not something that is concrete. The silence is everywhere. Silence is in the pauses, is in the breaks, is in daily life and in conversations. It is creating possibilities. The silence makes an opening for experiences around you. So it's actually a gate towards the very alive, living world and seeing the city around you. One of the projects we did in Brussels was inviting students of the radio school to make recordings of silence of their city by doing walks around and finding places that for them signified a silent experience, and bringing this back to the audience by making compositions in four tracks based on their silent explorations. Silence led us to a different perception of the city around us, in the sense that in this silent walks and the silent exploration, we were as well looking for empty, abandoned spaces in the city, and to see how they fit in, how the dialogue or differ of the city fabric. And for this we had a series of activities with students of the Athens School of Architecture that first were invited to explore an empty museum. The very strange thing in Athens was that a new museum for contemporary art was built, but it stayed empty for 3 years because there was no money to bring the works of art, which was stored at the other side of the city, to the museum and to hang them there. When this money was found, the week before, we were asked to sort of celebrate this empty museum, which was completely working, with working elevators, escalators, with a completely installed bar, the lights. But just the only thing that was missing were the works of art. And so we were proposed to make a performance about experiencing, recording, interacting with the silence in this museum by making a walk with students and other performance in the spaces. In this process of walking an empty museum, we recorded silence again, and as well try to feel the silence, to sense the silence, to make it a physical experience by moving with it. Other walks we did in Athens were walks in abandoned places, like in the Eleonas area, which, strangely enough, Athens, which is a huge city with 5 million people living there, which is packed. It's in a valley, and it's not having enough space for everybody to live there. But still, in this very dense population, there are places that are completely empty, like a field that is called Eleonas, which is quite big, in which there are trees, little paths, and till the horizon, but which is not built and is only have abandoned buildings around it. We made a silent walk with the students there, asking them as well both to record and both to record with their body the silence and with a sound device, which was translated afterwards in another sound walk using a software to recreate this experience of emptiness that they had in the walk. For others to walk with their smartphone around. In Brussels, we did a similar project. And 1 month after the unfortunate terrorist attacks, which was a very delicate thing to do, to go back to a city which was in a state of crisis, and then to come with the proposal to use silence an artistic way to have an influence for the better on the city and the environment. In a moment that people were asking for actions and not for a more silent, tender, delicate way of interacting with their environment. We went to Molenbeek, which was the most problematic area of Brussels. Actually, there, most of the terrorist attacks that happened in France, in Germany en in as well in Belgium were planned. Due to political problems and a very big division of the city. The city was divided in 70 police zones, which were not really communicating that the terrorists had this possibility to live and gather there and plan there. And in this specific area, we did silent walks, listening to what the environment, how the people are interacting with each other, and creating this as well again in a sound walk, and using a software that we developed for this project, and which allows you a three-dimensional experience. For us, walking is not a linear. It's something that allows you to drift, to go around wherever you want to go without having a beginning point or an end point, but to as well to compose your own trajectory. Most software that allow you to use your smartphone for the making a media walk or a video walk or sound walk in the city, they bring you from place to place, and on these places you have a content triggered. What we wanted to make, or we wanted to make possible, was a software and media walks that you can compose yourself. And not only you can compose yourself by walking your own trajectory, but as well to be able to use the points with the media or the sounds in such a way that they don't disappear, but that they stay around you as they are present. Like you are walking to an orchestra, and when you go from one musician to another, that when you come to the next one, that the musician behind you or next to you or diagonally from you is not disappearing, but still is there. So to have a completely immersive experience, a completely spontaneous, intuitive experience of walking through using technology. In all our project, essential is that the tools we give are open source, are open access, are free, are meant to give people the chance to experiment with and actually to tell their stories, to bring their experiences to a larger community and audience. Dus the platform we make, Geon Composite, is also a community platform that allows you to walk and to explore the experience others have put in their designed sound walk. For everybody who wants to download it and to communicate about it. It brings people together. This led to a series of exhibitions in Edinburgh, in Athens, and where we worked together about the aspect of sound walking with students, where we invited young artists to create for us the artistic walks, like the light walks, which were inspired by the idea of botanizing the asphalt, but as well by walking around with a little light in the city, leaving behind words that are given to the city. This is inspired as well by the ancient Greek philosophy, where Diogenes, the philosopher, was walking around with a lantern in broad daylight, looking for the human being. And as well inviting artists working with technology to use technological developments in art in creating works of art indoors that relate to walking, like this perspective installation that allows you to move around in the marked fields together with two persons and create a city through your movements. You build little by little. In moving towards each other, moving together, you create from empty a complete city that is in sound and in image. Another exhibition we did was in Cyprus, which was based on the fact of simultaneity. We invited a group of people, students, to walk together all over the world. This was in Lesbos, in Greece, on the place which was which is the island where many refugees come on their first step in their long journey through Europe, in the New York, in Athens, in Brussels, to have dialogues through their walks, which were by simultaneously walking and sharing their experiences, like recordings, like videos, like photographs, with each other, but as well in using the materials of the others in making media walks or sound walks on the smartphone in their city, so you can walk the others' walk by using your device. Again, inviting as well people that work with movement in their artistic practice to recreate walks indoors, like with dance and with in relation to videos, the in and outside. This goes again together with a collaborative process. A collaborative process bringing together different labs and schools and studios all over the world. I initiated in the Royal Academy of Fine Arts in Brussels on Walking Lab. That is the focal point of all these groups, including the Walking as a Practice studio in Parsons by Lydia Matthews, bringing together as well these experiences of walking together at the same time in Athens and in New York City, which is a very specific experience because in New York you walk during the day, in Athens you walk during the night, and at the same time you are sharing your experiences of walking at the same time together and still walking in different parts of the day. As well in Cyprus, where the laboratory is now created, investigating silence through walking in the city and in Athens. We are looking further to extend this network with other people, artists, researchers, and organizations, institutions around the world who share the same interest for walking with us. And this will extend now to Tirana, and we are looking forward to find more partners in the future. This was really a snapshot of what I do. I wanted to give you a drift through my work and my activities and to create the possibility as well to exchange with you your comments, ideas about these approaches.
When you have people walking simultaneously in different places, and I know are they walking in silence as well? And then what do they do at the end? Do they talk to each other or share photos or what's the...
Yes, they have moments that they have breaks in cafes and they go on Skype and they have conversations about their walks. So it's not a complete silent experience. They have a personal conversation as well, but that is happening on moments after or during the walk when they take a break to have this exchange.
What are they discovering? What are they talking about? I'm just sort of interested. What are they finding when they're doing this?
The very strange thing is that you are one side you're walking inside your own city, having this environment around you, at the same time watching your screen and seeing other places or hearing what is around in other cities, the conversations of the people that are walking with you but in another place. So the whole experience is more about being in two places at the same time, which is at one side, this is alienating you from what are you experiencing, at the same time creating a different way of intimacy by being in a place where with the other in the virtual space that is a shared space as much as the physical place that you are in.
Okay. Oh, hi.
Yes,
hello. Good evening, and thank you for being here. I teach urban studies here in Chicago, and my students in American cities often need an outlier, and much of it is walkable. Have you had curious experiences walking in U.S. cities? You can tell us about the good, the bad, dare I say the other?
The experience I have working in the U.S. is limited to New York. It's the only city next to Portland, which I visited last week. And Boston, where I arrived this night, last night. So in New York, it's very difficult to walk slowly, to walk just to enjoy walking. You're always like hunted. You feel like pushed, and just to stand still is impossible. And that inspired me and a local artist, Maria Elisa Burgos Melendez, which is a dancer who is from Puerto Rico, to do a slow walk in the Puerto Rico Avenue the last week, both as a gesture towards her home country, by being aware of what is around her, and also by interacting with the people around in this slowness, because this is people ask you questions. Why are you going so slow? Why? What is happening? So we started both at one side of this avenue, which is exactly 1 mile long. We decided to walk for 30 minutes as slow as possible, and after 30 minutes to stop whatever we arrived. And or seeing each other or not, or passing each other or not. And in the meanwhile, try to create an openness for people to interact with us, even if we were in the silence mode. This led to some very interesting meetings, discussions, conversations, and is a way to be in the place, really, what is otherwise impossible in a city as New York.
Thank you.
Yes, and in the Eastern traditions, there are wonderful approaches to that. One of these approaches is, for example, to walk with half a smile. So you are invited to make a very long walk, which can be like 3 hours, but not with a complete smile, not with a half a smile. And be focused on your facial expression all the time during walking, which makes you aware of your body on a very intense way. In the Eastern tradition, they have this. For them, walking is more than even more than in the Western a way of being.
Have you explored in your work how walking could be expanded to mobility?
Yes, I worked in previous projects do you say disabled in English? Is the correct word? Yes. The disabled artists and dancers. not only about walking, but about movement. So one of the projects we did, and what was the big project before I started with Made of Walking, was called Mediterranean Bodies, and brought together young artists, young movement artists and dancers from all over Europe to create an underwater dance performance. By taking away the gravity, making it possible for them to move freely, as well out of the idea that underwater there were no borders. So people from different countries, from the Middle East, from Africa and from Europe, can move freely without being limited by not only their physical borders, but by the physical borders of countries, which was a very big challenge. We had to create a composition to be played underwater. The audience was as well underwater. You had to follow a diving course to be able to take part in it. And but this going further, we had as well with disabled artists and dancers, we organize mixed performances in which we invite them to work, to dialogue together, to create together as artists, as media artists, but as well as performance artists on the streets. So by making street art together, bringing in as well the awareness about, especially in southern countries where I work the most, like in Athens or in Portugal, where no attention at all is given to disabled people. For Greek drivers, a pavement is a parking spot. So we try on an indirect way to make people aware about the limitations of movement in the city, using more playful interventions. Another thing we do is just gather a bunch of young musicians and walk in places where people are afraid to come. Athens is a very divided city. You have the historical touristical center where you are safe, but once you go out of this, you come in very, sometimes very scary places. So to make this more livable, we invite people to walk there in groups and using creativity, leaving things behind, for example, to from an abandoned parking lot to make a little park, to paint the stairs that is leading to another level of the street in different colors, or just to play music there and to gather there, to have a picnic there. So that sort of things is also part of my practice, which is not always institutionalized, but can also be very the personal with residents. Eh? Actually, one more the detail about that. This is started with a group of people, with 8 people. We started an initiative which is called Atenistas, out of the need to do something, because the government was not doing something. Then we said, let's do it ourselves. And although this was a very small group, these 8 people grew to a network of 10,000 people that are doing little things in the street, even to repair a clock on the street that is not working anymore, till renovating an abandoned building by painting it. Now this is a community of over 80,000 people online, and 10,000 people that are engaging in activities, using walks as well as a way to be more aware of the problems and try to do something about it, not to wait to somebody to do something for you. Atenistas. Mm-hmm. The whole idea is as well that walking can be, that walking can be something that you enjoy, and to bring that to people. Wendy about Boston does as advocates for walking is trying to create possibilities for people to walk. What I try to do is to create possibilities for people to walk and to enjoy it, and to share it.
Thank you.
Thank you.